very excited to be here. I think we've had an exciting season. I think that we're a little bit like Tennessee in the sense that we've kind of gone on a run as of late, as Tennessee has, and had some amazing come-from-behind wins. And so I'm really looking forward to the atmosphere here, and just an exciting time for softball. So,
Coming out of the College World Series last year, was this like, did you go into the season expecting this was the realistic goal you wanted to be in Super Regional?
Definitely. Super Regionals World Series was definitely our goal. And with what we had returning with Maddie and Lacey and some experienced players, felt very comfortable that the experience to give back to our freshmen coming in was going to be good. But we knew we had to have a tough schedule and really work through that. So was our goal, but really had to know as we went through the season to keep our kids, our freshmen's heads above water and make sure that, you know, that they knew that this was the process and stay the course. And it's been really neat to see the last 3 weeks them come together as a unit.
U.S. Tennessee played in, what, February? Are those results meaningful now, or has so much happened since that?
Yeah, I think two completely different teams, and I think just the opportunity to play that level of softball out in Palm Springs, and I think we challenge ourselves, and as did Tennessee, playing that level of softball, knowing that when you get to this time of year, you can go back on the style of play, the athleticism, all those things, but yet the characters of the team are completely different right now.
What's the biggest way in which you've improved since that point? Obviously, it was really, really early in the season, but what's the most progress you've shown since then?
Yeah, well, I think that the biggest thing right now is the experience. I mean, obviously, teams right now are very skilled, and you know, when you get to 16 and the World Series, 8 teams, they're very athletic and very skilled. But it's the experience and the team chemistry that really pulls you through to that next step. And so we have a lot of young kids in a lot of positions right now, and in order to gain weekends and week out of playing that level of ball and win, lose, or draw, just getting the experience as a team together pulls you through at this time of year. So the camaraderie, the experience, and being in a lot of big situations and big games.
How important are the veterans this time of year? They've been through the Super Regional. They've made it to the College World Series. How do they help those young players this time of year?
Yeah, I think upperclassmen are huge for you because they have been in a lot of those big games. The big thing for Bailey, Maddie, and Lacey and some of our juniors was just to stay even keel and let the young ones kind of go through the ups and downs of the season and be that consistent vision for them. And then every now and again, an arm around the shoulder is kind of good too because they've been in a lot of those situations that maybe Morgan and Jessica have been through.
Coach, a lot has been made of y'all's pitching staff, but what have you seen from Tennessee's hitters and the challenge they might present in the plate this weekend?
Yeah, very passionate. You know, not only are they skilled, we already know that everyone's going to be pretty good at this point in time, but the way they're playing, the style of ball they're playing is very passionate. They're passing the bat to each other with just trying to make something happen. I mean, the top of the lineup's doing some things, but actually the bottom lineup's really come through for them as of late. They're playing 7 innings of ball, so you know, you may get through 3 or 4 innings, but they're definitely coming on late too and doing some things. So you know, power, obviously got some good power and just making a lot of things happen and really working good at bats.
To that end, why has your pitching staff been so successful this season?
Yeah. you know, I think we have a really good pitching staff, and a lot of times you just see one name. I mean, Lacey's been very good for us, and Jessica's kind of been under her wing for a while. Now Jessica's starting to come out and do pretty good things for us, but we also have Bailey Chanella to go to too, just like Tennessee staff. You know, it's pitched by committee, and we've been a lot like that too. And so I think they're really good at knowing what they're good at and being comfortable with that. And then sometimes when they have to get outside the box a little bit, they trust in the process and they trust in the coaching staff to be able to do that.
Obviously, y'all have a really good team ERA, but it seems across the country, scoring at record rates.
Yeah.
Why do you think the game has changed in that way the last couple of years?
I think it's honestly the umpire strike zones changed a little bit, and I'm a big fan of it. I think it's awesome. I think you know, I know a lot of pitching coaches, and I am a pitching coach. So they get frustrated with the, you know, quote unquote, I don't know where the river came in, but the river. And you know, I think that if we want to be really good in the circle, we want 9 hitters, 10 hitters to be able to work at the plate. And so right now, it's been a more consistent, what people would call a tighter zone, what I think is a really good zone. And it's been more consistent. It makes the pitchers work. It makes the defense work. But you know when you get out of innings, your hitters are going to have something to work with, and they're not going to have to worry about too wide of a zone.
How are you seeing it called differently? Like, what did the zone end up looking like a few years ago versus what it seems like now?
You know, chalk to chalk. It used to be pretty wide. I know World Series a while ago, it could even be batter's box. And unfortunate, there's 20 kids in your team that work out, and 4 of them may be pitchers. So the 16 kids aren't getting an opportunity and a fair shake. And so I think it's worked out to be a lot better right now.
You know, if Tennessee hadn't gotten red hot in the SEC tournament and upset some big RPI teams,
yeah,
we might be in Tallahassee today,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's right. Now, yeah, I think we heard an earful of it with UCF last week, and you know they should have had a chance to host, and you know you can get in the politics of it, and unfortunately, you know it kind of is what it is at some point. And you go out as a coach and you try to put yourself in the best schedule possible. You try to mark some games that are going to be really big for you, but when that list comes out and you go in for Selection Show Sunday, get over it. This is what you have, and we got to move forward. And so so we're excited to be here. Yes, it would have been nice as a 7 RPI finishing out to be able to host, but this is just another challenge, and I think it's great for our program to be here.
Is it an oversimplification to bill it as Tennessee's hitters against your pitchers, or do you think that's fair?
No, I think it's fair. I honestly think that when you get in this time of year, I mean, you're going to have your headlines, whatever they are, but I mean, it's going to come down to just execution all the way around, taking advantage of extra 60 feet, you know, handling some of the pressures of the game. In big stages like this, the game doesn't change. You know, it's still like you're playing the same style of ball you were the first 10 games or what you're trying to achieve too, but now you're going to have a lot more at stake. And as long as we all can kind of relax and just play our game, we're going to be okay.
And do you feel like the ACC season is good preparation for this?
I think, you know, we've had probably one of the more competitive ACC conferences this year than we ever have, and I'm really excited about that. And having 7 teams into postseason is really big for us, and seeing what Pittsburgh did, you know, in a short amount of time and doing some things is really good for us. So, yes, I think that we need to schedule. I think we scheduled a pretty tough schedule early on, and so we were able to balance that a little bit, where – you know, you look at an SEC schedule, it may be a little different going into the end and, you know, their conference time. But we're definitely road warriors. We can handle that. And I think that, you know, our come-from-behind wins have really given us a lot of confidence where we're at right now.